So atrial fibrillation and heart failure are the two global pandemics in the cardiovascular arena. They both tend to worsen the outcomes of each other. And so there's been lots of interest in improving those outcomes over the last 20 years or so. Historically, the rhythm control strategy used to involve cardioverting these people and giving them antiarrhythmic drugs. And the historical trials show no difference with that strategy, i.e. no improvement. More recently, with catheter ablation, the chances of maintaining sinus rhythm are much higher, and hence there have been lots of head-to-head randomized controlled trials which have addressed this very issue. So it's very difficult to know, as an individual patient, what best to do, because it's such a wide spectrum of patients. There are some people in whom atrial fibrillation is the fundamental reason for the heart failure, or at least it's contributing to the heart failure. And it's those patients we really want to address with ablation. Equally, there are some patients in whom atrial fibrillation happens as a byproduct of long-standing heart failure, almost as an end-stage disease. In them, there's little to be gained by doing catheter ablation. So far, the trials that I have done have not made a distinction between these two subtypes. So essentially, all comers with heart failure and atrial fibrillation have been included in these trials. The most important thing we need is to identify those patients with atrial fibrillation and heart failure who are likely to benefit from rhythm control with catheter ablation. So you're enriching that population and making the risks and the expense of catheter ablation worthwhile in these patients. So the most important thing to consider is that patients with congestive heart failure are very different from your usual AF ablation population. These patients are often sicker, they're often older, they have lots of comorbidities, so the risk of complications is much higher. So you need to be aware that you're bringing your A game to the table when you're doing AF ablation in these people. So you need to do, you need to use the best technology, you need to be minimalistic in terms of what you can achieve, because these patients often cannot tolerate long procedures, and you need to be realistic in your expectations. Well, first of all, be aware that now there are good quality data showing that rhythm control with catheter ablation improves outcomes in these patients. So often these patients feel better, they have better objective criteria for performance, such as 6-minute walk distance, levels of NT-proBNP levels, and often they live longer as well if you follow up these patients long enough. So the awareness is key, and that education needs to be disseminated all through the primary providers and secondary providers.